These are the headlines for today. Intestinal microbiome, key in the prevention of obesity and type 2 diabetes, new study says. Unsterilized microbes brought from Mars might present risk and hazard to Earth's biosphere. And your electric vehicle can soon be charged on the road while you're driving it. Hello there, welcome to today's edition of MW Newscast. My name is Michael. These are the details of the stories. First story, Rhythmic small intestinal microbiome prevents obesity and type 2 diabetes. The human body hosts trillions of microbes or bacteria. Some of these are useful and some are harmful. It is estimated that there are 500 to 1,000 bacterial species in every human gut, perhaps numbering 100,000 trillion microorganisms. Yet, they make up only about 2-3% of the total weight of the human body, despite outnumbering the cells. Researchers at the University of California, San Diego School of Medicine, have used mouse models to study how diet and feeding patterns affect its gut microbes and the health status of the host, especially with obesity and type 2 diabetes. The study found that the amount of food ingested and the time altered the nature of the gut microbiome. Recurring changes in the gut microbiome are important for health since they help with the circadian rhythms, and with that, the regulation and control of glucose, cholesterol, and fatty acids. Too much food too frequently results in poorer microbial and metabolic health. Thus, eat just enough healthy foods at the appropriate times. Next story, NASA plans to bring Mars samples to Earth. Is it safe? Since September last year, the Perseverance Mars rover has been collecting rocks and soil samples from the red planet and storing them in titanium tubes. The Mars Sample Return MSR program being planned by NASA and the European Space Agency ESA would pick up the geologic and atmospheric samples and bring them to Earth in the early 2030s. Then, scientists will start testing for signs of ancient microbial life from about 35 samples weighing in total about 1 pound. In light of the recent pandemic, bringing unsterilized microbes from Mars might present risks and hazards to Earth's biosphere and human health. Is it safe to bring them to Earth? Different panels of scientific experts from the United States and elsewhere over the past several decades have analyzed the situation and have found an extremely low likelihood that samples collected from areas on Mars could possibly contain a biological hazard to our biosphere. NASA and ESA engineers are focused on designing and delivering a multi-layered containment system capable of bringing Mars samples safely with standards of industries such as medicine and aviation. Additionally, meteorites from Mars have many times landed on the Earth's surface, so far without adverse effects. Last story for today, electric roads to charge your car while you drive. The issue of charging electric vehicles, EVs, seems too often be the main problem critics or skeptics raise, bringing up questions of how easy it is to find a charging point, how fast is it to charge the vehicle, and so on. These problems could soon be the thing of the past. Can you imagine charging your EV on the move, with no wires involved at all? Researchers are developing electric roads that can charge your car wirelessly while waiting at the traffic light or even while on the road. In Sweden, a pilot project on the holiday island of Gotland has transformed a 1.6-kilometer stretch of road into a wireless energy charging dock capable of powering a bus via a process called induction. The electric vehicle has a wireless receiver placed on the bottom of the car, which must coincide with the charge coil positioned beneath the road surface for the power to be transferred to the EV. Wonderful, hopefully this technology becomes a reality around the world. And that's all for today's edition. Thanks for watching MW Newscast. Subscribe and hit the like button and share the news with your friends and contacts. Once again, my name is Michael, and see you on the next edition.